everybody. It is a brisk 30 something degree morning right now. We're headed out to a tractor trailer flatbed rollover that is less than a block away from our shop. That always makes things handy. We're gonna go out here, get on scene, assess the situation. Police didn't have a whole lot of information for us, but I'll just let you guys ride alone because I'm gonna make this left turn. It's gonna be right here. Loaded with roofing material, didn't he? I feel like we're gonna more than likely have to offload it. Oh. Yeah. A lot of it's probably not salvageable. Especially this back here. What is this? Is like cardboard. Are you loaded at a full 40? 72. 72? Okay. What is this stuff?
It's a red wing tile. It's like fibrous
roofing tile. Gotcha. So it has zero durability. Yeah, this is 100% going to be an offload.
You already called them up and have them closed down? Or?
I have not. I was just going to have you guys call state. No, because we're gonna have to we're gonna close the whole Glenwood mill though. All right.
Except for our truck.
We're loaded at 72,000. This is gonna be an offload and then a rollover.
Training day.
Yeah, training with the Tiger Tool too. So, yep. Maybe better off to go over there. They come in.
Yeah.
I said okay.
Which one you want?
Huh? Red, it's easier.
You boom up, strip.
Yep.
Drag us with the tractor?
Yeah. You'll need a chain down there anyway. Matt, 12 foot blue. How do you want to rig to the truck?
We're doing a straight line. Just unhook it.
Oh, wait, hang on. I was thinking, what do you want rigging for the truck? Do you want a 12 foot blue strap, or how do you want to rig to the truck?
Yeah, with some pads around the frame.
Over there?
We're going to straight line pull it.
Okay.
Enough out of white to just let it hang, you think? Adam, that's probably enough out of that line to just let it hang.
I like that.
Okay.
Once we go tight, Huggy can
lock it in.
Lock it in and get it tight.
What are you looking for?
On
your left. You want clevis for the tree?
Yeah. Want the truck rail? Or hooks fitting in?
Well, let me grab you a bigger one.
You got a snap lock down here?
No, I'll grab it. Daniel! Snatch block! Snatch block! Yeah. Where's the chain off that tractor?
Right
Do you need another one? Behind you, Daniel. You gonna need a, what is that for? A tree?
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you need?
Let's take it down there. Really, that one is thicker. That one's a bigger chain. It'll work. Yeah. We're still probably
needing clevis and glutes, round strap. No, clevis and a cable.
Yeah. Clevis right on the chain. They don't really matter on a chain, but I usually hook the hook to the bolt. The radio out of the passenger seat. Shovel?
Yeah, probably. Well, you can't get it up here. Don't worry about it. No.
Won't miss that hole.
Yeah. You guys got everything ready up here?
get them pieces off the top up of this one.
Slide on.
There you go. Hang on. Gotta get the slide them this way. Thank you. mess. She's back on her wheels. Gonna do some cleanup. Then we gotta winch the whole thing back there to flatter ground before we pull it up out. Yeah. Been a heck of a day. Now we gotta do the long winch.
Which battery you got, man?
I got three more in the cab. I've been swapping them out all day.
I'm gonna try to stay in this lane.
You what?
I was gonna try to stay in that lane with
you. Yeah. He may have to reset. Huh?
Pull the tractor now. We're up on the pavement.
Right? I'm probably gonna get you like you are, get your truck back on the road. I'll probably pick a trailer up and slide it over. Yeah, pick him up.
Pick him up?
Yeah.
Okay.
Slide him over. What?
Yes.
That, or tell him to put it, go up there, Steven, and tell him to straighten the wheel up, and we're gonna let the cable out and get him straight up in the road. Now, what I'll have you do is hook this one up and take the green one out. Roll it up about that diameter, and you open that toolbox on the passenger side, the big toolbox door,
yeah,
on the door hanging on the lower end. And then there's a tarp strap. Take the tarp strap and run across it. You can go over there and you can see how big you got to wind it. Probably gonna have you back at her. Can you turn it around somewhere up here?
Shit, I was gonna back it all.
That's what I was gonna say. I put Steven in or Jimmy or in the van behind you with their lights off or whatever, or have them turn around and stay behind you while you're backing up. He's gonna back the land all back up, because you go back it all the way up to Kevin Carr's parking lot and turn in. Huh?
Hey Matt, you want me to take the
forklift? Yeah, take the forklift on back.
Put shit up?
Yep. They'd have never said that unless you said that. All right, grab your hook over there. Hook it on this ring. Your blue one. I got your free spool so you can come back up. And then hook it to your top ring. Yeah, up here on top. Huh? No, these up here. Starter fork. Now, you have to pull your pin on the front.
Yeah.
And slide it a little bit, because you always want it right in the center of your U-bolts right here. Yeah, you gotta play with it. Try to get them as centered as you can. That way when you're going down the road, you ain't gotta worry about it coming off your forks. Pull out and hold on it, and then slide your thing either way you wanna go. Looks like you're good. You're pretty much in center, ain't you? All right, good. Don't worry about the pin now. Huh? No. You gotta start it. You gotta get a good hard angle. And these are backwards.
Yeah, I've seen that.
He rebuilt the whole truck and put the tags on backwards.
Oh, I got you. You're saying this is...
So in is out. All right, look underneath there and get me guided up on the axle.
Get it lined up in the center of it. It'll spin around. You can pivot the head up, guys.
Go out. Four. All right, now go up.
Mike's on. All right.
Now you're good to go up. There you go, pick her up.
We on? I am now.
So I'm assuming you got that cylinder base.
Yes.
Be on the left side of the bottom.
Yep.
We don't have the little silver turns?
No, we use straps. You got it? Now guys, the younger guys, never get underneath that crossbar when it's up in the air. Because if anything happens, well, right there where they're at right now, you don't even want to put your hand underneath it, especially your head. You'll see a lot of guys lay underneath it. Just understand that if anything goes wrong, you will not know you're dead. Because anything happens with any of these lines, 50 to 60 feet of line, hydraulic hose, anything could go wrong. At any given second, she collapses. So don't be the guy stuck underneath the T-bar when she collapses. So always try to work from the side, and it's even safer to put blocks up right your tires right now and block it up. That way if something does happen, it's not gonna kill anybody. Okay.
You gonna run into toys on, don't you think?
Huh?
You gonna have one of them on the track?
Yeah, yeah. Thanks for help, bud. Oh, my truck's like, thank God. Thank you. Yeah. Huh?
Make sure the trailer's rolling.
clear? Everybody clear? Yeah, it would have never done that before. One tilt.